Penguin Random House Audio presents My Money, My Way, Taking Back Control of Your Financial Life. This is the author, Kumiko Love. To all of the women who have lost hope with their finances, it's time to start a new journey your way. Introduction and a note on honoring yourself. We women are forever telling ourselves two lies, that we're bad with money and that we don't have anything to wear. While this book won't exactly help you with the latter, though Madewell jeans are 100% worth saving for, it will help you with your money goals like no book has ever before. No more feeling out of control with your finances. No more skyrocketing debt, no more stress and anxiety and constant worry, and most important, no more traditional budgeting. Traditional budgets fail because they focus exclusively on the numbers. Moreover, they're entirely too restrictive, anxiety-producing, and disempowering. They leave us dependent on people out there who know the secret. Despite all the fancy step-by-step programs that purportedly break the big concepts down into specific bite-sized instructions, traditional budgeting still leaves you overwhelmed, confused, and unsure you're doing it right as you bend over backward to follow rules you don't understand. Worse, you feel resentful of being made to feel like a child who constantly has to slap herself on the wrist when she spends. And when all of that restricting results in failure, you'll berate yourself for your lack of discipline. What's wrong with me? Why can't I ever seem to get it together? But discipline alone is not enough. You need more discipline, and this book. I'm Kumiko Love, founder of the leading personal finance website, The Budget Mom, creator of the Budget by Paycheck method, and an accredited financial counselor who helps millions of women around the world reinvent their money stories. And I take a different approach to money, one that actually relies very little on the numbers. Money is never a conversation about numbers. When we talk about money, we're talking about so much more than that. We're talking about emotional health. We're talking about happiness. We're talking about the quality of your life. Your financial health is your emotional health, and that's something women aren't taught. We feel guilty about money, have trouble saving money, have issues asking for money, spend money when we feel good, spend money when we feel bad, don't know how to manage it, don't know what to do with it, don't know how much we have of it, and certainly don't know how much we need. And that's because so many of the decisions we make with our money are tied to how we feel about ourselves in any given moment of time. We spend money out of panic, fear, insecurity, low self-esteem, anxiety, doubt, shame, and all sorts of complex human emotions that, frankly, are really messing with our quality of life. That's what this book is about. Regardless of your income level or your credit card balance, you deserve to live well. You deserve to save with dignity, and you deserve to spend money towards your own unique dreams. That's what I call My Money, My Way. And it's about what you do need more than what you shouldn't buy. I can't tell you how many women I've seen drastically overcorrect their money habits by depriving themselves of joy. It breaks my heart to see people deny themselves because they are afraid of the financial consequences, because they aren't prepared, or, worst of all, because someone told them that particular experience was off limits. When a new mom shames herself for going out to eat with her friends because she wasn't supposed to. When a person automatically assumes they can't afford to go back to school. When you don't ever buy organic because it's for rich people. That's not how we're going to live. Instead, we're going to manage our money and, by extension, our lives from a place of strength. We're going to start with asking what you need your money to do for you. How do you want your money to serve you? How can the act of budgeting be a way to honor yourself rather than deny yourself? If you're like, yeah, okay, Miko, try honoring my negative bank balance. I get it. This is the hard part, at least at first. But it isn't because you're bad with money. I promise. It's because you're operating under outdated and false assumptions about your money and the role it plays in your life. Here's the thing. Financially anxious people don't know themselves, what they're aiming for, or what actually makes their lives full. They don't know what makes them happy. Consequently, they spend money on things and experiences out of a subconscious insecurity, out of a need to fit in or become someone else, or because they have no idea what really brings value to their lives. For example, when a woman gets her nails done every week because all the other women do, but she carries credit card debt because of it. Or when a student blows money on a concert to see a band she doesn't like because her friends are all going, and then the next week doesn't have money for books. They don't know what a life of freedom and abundance means to them because they haven't yet defined those things for themselves. Until you know who you are, what you want, and how you desire to live your life, how could you possibly know how to manage your money? This is what I'm going to teach you in My Money, My Way. I won't be giving you a rigid set of rules about how much you can and can't spend at Starbucks. You don't need those. Instead, I'm going to teach you how to think about money differently so you can make different decisions. You'll be making those decisions based on your very unique situation, your personal values, your driving emotions, your particular needs. Once you figure out that criteria, your financial plan will practically write itself. It's not about deprivation, but desire, because you are not the problem. Shame is the problem. Guilt is the problem. Society's expectations are the problem. You are the solution. I hope this book gives you the confidence to trust yourself. I hope this book gives you the bright, open heart to try again. And I hope this book makes you shine. Chapter 1: The Ice Cream Cone That Changed My Life. Some couples fight about money, but my ex-husband and I had an even bigger problem. We didn't talk about it at all. He would give me his paycheck, and I would pay the bills. And while that might sound like we're adults of the year, what we really were was clueless. Plans? What were those? We were winging it daily. Neither one of us caring enough about our finances to even have a conversation. The day I got pregnant, however, we were finally forced to take a harder look at things. How are we going to afford a baby? I told myself we would make it work. We would find ways to be thrifty. I painted the nursery walls myself, a light green color, with paint I found in the clearance section at Home Depot. I watched DIY videos on YouTube and tutorials on Pinterest. I made bookshelves from old rain gutters and made all of the artwork for the baby's bedroom out of construction paper and Crayola markers. I was determined to create special memories with the little money we had. It would be fine. We would just wing it like we always did. But then I actually had the baby. If you've ever looked into the eyes of a newborn, you know it upends everything you thought about what matters. For the first time, day by day was not good enough. Seat of my pants was not good enough. My son, James, made me long for an all-new sense of stability, a life that was beautiful, intentional, safe, and designed.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.